Hello students, Sai Ram. Welcome to our online session. So today I'm going to take English subject. I hope you all are ready. Good. So first I'm going to show you one picture. By seeing this picture, just say, which season is this? Yes, this is rainy season. I know you all of you like this rainy season. Yes, students? Now, here we are going to do poem about this rainy season. This poem number is 11. Title of the poem is Who Likes the Rain? So here the poet wants to find out who all likes the rain. Even animals, flowers, human beings, and the nature. Okay, it's all like the rains. So this poem is going to tell who all like the rain. Okay, students. So here it comes. I said the duck, I call it fun, for I have my red rubbers on. They make a little three-toed track in the soft, cool mud. Quack, quack. So quack, quack means who is this? It's a duck. This duck is very happy by seeing the rain. It loves the rain. The duck describes, duck is saying as, my red rubbers. Red rubbers means its webbed feet. Yes, its webbed feet. This feet is three-toed track. That means it's keeping its feet in the soft, cool mud and it comes a feet. Print. Yes, footprint it comes. So it likes that. This duck likes this doing footprint. So that's why it's very happy and making the sound of quack quack. Okay, students. So this means this duck loves the rain. So who likes the rain? This is a poem name. Title of the poem is Who Likes the Rain? So duck says, I said the duck, I called it fun, for I have my red rubbers on. They make a little three-toed track in the soft, cool mud. Quack, quack. So this stanza explains about the duck, how the duck enjoys the rain and taking the footprint. Where is it taking the footprint? In the soft, cool mud and making the sound quack, quack. Okay. This is your first stanza. Now second stanza. Okay, second stanza. Who is this? I cried the dandelion. My roots are thirsty. My buds are dry. And she lifted a tousled yellow head out of her green and grassy bed. So who is this dandelion? Dandelion, student, it's a yellow flower. Okay, this yellow flower also loves the rain. It's saying, if the rain was not there, my roots are thirsty and my buds become dry. Why? Because rain was not there. Now the rain has come, so I'm very happy. And my tousled means messy yellow head. So you can see the messy yellow head out of a green grassy bed. So how it become green? By the rain. Yes? So your meaning is, dandelion means a kind of small yellow flower. Tousled means messy. Okay. One more time. I cried the dandelion. My roots are thirsty. My buds are dry. And she lifted a tousled yellow head out of her green grassy bed. Okay, students. So this flower also likes the rain, loves the rain very much. And if the rain was not there, so this flower is saying, the roots are thirsty, my buds are dry. Okay. And she lifted a tousled. Tousled means messy yellow head out of her green and grassy bed. Okay, students, I hope you understood. Now next stanza. I hope tea will pour. I hope tea will pour. Pour the tree top at the gray park door, for with a broad leaf for a roof. I am perfectly waterproof. Who is saying this? This is frog. Yes, the frog, the toad means frog. The frog is saying here, I am also very happy. It should pour continuously. It will pour. It will pour. It will pour. Pour and pour. Pour the tree toad at the gray bark door. So, this frog is standing beside the tree. And this was standing beside the tree with the help of the broad leaves. Okay, with the help of the broad leaves for a roof. Protection as a form of an umbrella. Okay, using the broad leaf. Okay, using the broad leaf for a roof. I'm perfectly waterproof. Okay, students. So, who is saying this? This frog. So, here, even frog also happy. The frog also wants rain. He loves the rain. So, this frog describe like he's taking the broad leaf for protection as a roof and is perfectly waterproof. Okay, students. So, here, tea will means it will. And here, bark means the rough outer covering of a tree. The rough outer covering of a tree. Okay, students? Now let's go to the next stanza. Sang the brook, I laugh at every drop and wish they never need to stop. Till a big, big river I grow to be and could find my way to the sea. So here the brook means small pool. And here the small pool, see how it is thinking, like if the rain will come, I'm going to become a big river. Okay, big river I'm going to become, and I'm going to find out the way to the sea. Yes, students, sang the brook. Who's brook? Brook means small river. I laugh at every drop. Drop means is very happy by putting the, but you can see the raindrops, and wish they never need to stop. So his wish is, the rain should not be stopped. See, this wish, it should become a big. See how you all are keeping your wish. When I will grow up, I wish I want to become a doctor. I'm going to become a policeman. Okay. I'm going to become a, like you can say, good millionaire. Yes, but how? You have to study well. Yes, students. So same way, see, this brook has its own thought. The brook thinks that if the rain comes continuously, I'm going to become a big river and I'm going to find out the way to the sea. Okay. See, here it is, you can see the small brook. Here you can see the brook means small river. Okay. Now, next stanza. I shouted, "Dad, for I can run with my high top boots and raincoat on to every puddle and runlet and pool I find on the road to school." So, who is Dad? Dad is this boy. See, humans, you also like rain very much. So, Dad is saying, with my high top boots. High top boot means gum boot. Yes, gum boot, you can see high top boots. And wearing raincoat, I will go through the puddle. Puddle means small pool. And runlet and pool. Runlet means a stream. Okay. And find on the road to the school. So happily is going to the school by wearing these all things and passing through the puddle and runlet and pool. Okay, so here this boy also very happy. This boy also likes the rain very much. So do you know who wrote this poem? It's a poet. A poet is Clara Doty Bates. Okay, so she is telling about who likes the rain. Animals, flowers, human beings. Yes, they all like the rain. Even we want rain. It's very important for us. Yes, students. So just this poet wants to find out who all likes the rain. I hope you all enjoyed this poem. Yes, students? Now it's a small surprise for you. Next is activity time. Okay. Here, activity time is, here is two picture. You can see the two picture? Yes, students. So here two pictures, you have to find out five differences. Okay, you have to find out five differences. Here, with the help of my brush, I'm going to find out the difference. First, I'm going from top left. Top left, here you can see I'm coming to cloud. Okay, here one difference, cloud. Okay, here in this left picture and right picture. Right picture is little mistake is there. You have to find out what mistake is here in right picture. So, left picture is correct picture. So, from left picture, you can see two insects are there. But in this picture, only one insect. Here, one difference, one, two. This way, out of five, you find out two. Now, you can see the eyes of the frog. Eyes of the frog, the directions are some changes. Is there difference? So, here it comes. One, three. One, two, three. Three difference you find out. Now, come down. Here, right hand side, leg, see, this patch is not there or a mark. Here, you can see, here, mark is not there. Give it up it over here. So, here, mark is not there. I put circle over here. Next, this frog is sitting on the rock. So, here is the another. The shape you can find out, see here, the shape is different. So I hope you all of you got it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This way you got it, the 5 difference. Okay. So let's see the answer. Here is your answer. So this is correct. I hope you all of you enjoyed. Yes. You have to first find out yourself. Okay. Afterwards you will see this answer. Now let's go to the textual questions. I hope you all are ready with your textbook. Come on, take out your textbook. Be ready. Page number 100. Okay. From 100 to 103. Okay, students. Here. So, here is your page number 100. First question is, choose the correct answer. The red rubbers of the dog are... How it looks, the options are, it's gumboot, it's web feet, it's umbrella. So, your answer is, it's web feet. Okay, students. Second one, the dandelion's head is tousled because the petals are dry. It did not comb its hair. It was playing. So, which one is your correct answer? Here is your correct answer. The petals are dry. Okay. Now third one. The tree toad is safe from the rain. Under a. Options are. Mushroom. Umbrella. Broad leaf. So your correct answer is. Broad leaf. Okay students. Write properly. Complete your textbook. Okay. With the help of this video, you can write. You can pause it and write this answer. Okay, students? Now, next question. Fourth one. The brook likes the rain because it wants to find its way to the dash. The options are river, lake, sea. So, here you are going to write sea. S-E-A-C. Okay, I hope you are doing good. Now, fifth one, Ted likes to run through the dash on the way to the school. See, the options are puddles, brook, ponds. What is your answer? Yeah, puddles. Okay, students, do it this properly with nice handwriting. complete your textbook. Now let's go to the next page. What sound do these animals make? Write these words in the correct bubbles. Okay, here one help box is given. With the help box, as per the according to the picture, you have to put this sound. Okay, ready? So first picture you can see, oh, it's a picture of duck. Duck make quack. Yes. Second picture, cow, cow moo. Third picture, hen. Hen makes sounds cluck. Fourth picture is owl. Here, howl, hoot. Horse, neigh. Goat or sheep, you can say baa. Yes, students. So this way you have to write with a pencil in your textbook. Okay. Now next one. Below that, there is one more. Find pairs with similar endings. Then fill those clouds with the same color. Okay. With the help of see. Here I am using this color. You can use your crayons color. Okay. Light color only you have to use. Don't use dark color. Okay. So what this question they say. They're asking us find the pairs which sounds similar. Okay, so here I took light color as yellow. Let's see. Okay, different color you have to use. Okay, students, pour yellow color. I am putting over here. You will color it full. I am just putting a shade. Pour floor. Okay, slowly you have to cover this cloud. Okay. The pair, whatever you are doing color, it should be equal, same. Okay, should be similar. Now, pour floor. Now, next, I am going to use another color, pink color. Boots. But students, you have to color full, huh? Light color only you have to use. Boots, roots. B-O-O-T-S, roots, R-O-O-T-S. I am just giving the shading. You will do it full color, okay? Now next is shook, rook. Another color I am going to use, purple color, light color, shook, brook. Okay, now next is, oh, another color I will take, green color. Here, hoof, roof. Okay, now next, twiddle, blue color, twiddle. Here, what's a similar? Fiddle. Okay, similar sounds, fiddle. Now next is, I am using again light color, light, yeah, red color, light, okay. Puddle, hurdle. Okay, so this way the pairs should be similar color, but when you are making a pair, one by one you will use the another colors. Okay, students, I hope you understood. Do it yourself, neatly, keep your book neat, okay? The color should not come out, okay? In that cloud only you have to do this coloring. Okay, students? Now let's go to the next question. Next page, page number 103. Write words which begins or end with the same consonants as these words. One has been done for you. Okay, so what they're saying, you can see the highlight words at red color, they're shown as a highlight, like highlight letters. Okay, and the same beginning letters, same ending letters. Ending letters they use blue color, and the beginning letter they would use red color. you don't use any color, you can write with your pencil. Okay, only with your pencil you can write. So these are some words. Let's start. Tree. Trap. T-R. Trap. T-R-A-P. Trap. Okay. Next ending word is E-E. Free. F-R-E-E. Free. Okay, students. I hope now you understood. Tree. T-R. Here, same beginning letters. T-R-A-P. Trap. So, tree. Last ending letters are E-E. So, same ending letters. Free. F-R-E-E. Okay. Now, third one. This one you will do. Then you will understand. Brook. Here, break. B-R-E-A-K. Break. Here, shook. S-H-O-O-K. Shook. Yes? O-O-K. You can find out other word also. No problem. Fourth one. Grape. G-R-A-P. Grape. Okay? Beginning letters. And pray. P-R-E-Y. Pray. Pray, I hope you all of you know. Pray means... Yes, prey means the animal is hunted by another animal. Okay. Bark. Next is bark. B-A-R-K. Here, bask. Okay, bask means taking a rest, finding out a place, lie down. Okay. Next, shark. S-H-A-R-K. Shark. I hope you all of you understood. Good. Now this way you have to do it in your textbook. Now let's come to next question. Read these lines aloud. Circle the sounds that are repeated. Here I'm using pink color. Okay, you can use your pencil. Okay, students. So here I'm going to circle. Go and first sentence, go and gather the green leaves on the grass. So here which letter, which sounds you can see, you can hear? Here is G. Only G you have to circle. G. Okay, G. Here also G. Okay, students, G, 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 G. Here you have to circle G. Now, next I am taking purple color. Second sentence. Paul planted the pretty pink poppies in the pot. Okay, so here sounds P. I am going to circle P. Only P. Only P. Only P. Only P, only P, only P. Okay, see here it's circle. I'm not able to properly, but students, you can do it in your book. Okay, with the help of the pencil, nicely. Only one letter, only one alphabet you have to circle. Now next one. Round and round she run. R. Round R. Sounds, yes. Here R, R, R. Oh, let me rub this. It's not in a proper place. Green. R. Okay, students. What I am saying, listen. Only that letter you have to circle. Okay. Fourth one. Bella buys a big black bag for her book. Here B, sound B, yellow color I took. B, students, with the pencil you have to do. Okay, no with the crayons, only with the pencil. B, B, here also B. Okay, you do it in your book properly. Okay, now next I am going to use blue. Fifth one. Javed jumped and made the jelly jingle. So J sounds J, J, and here jelly J, jiggle J. Oh, again it's mistake. I will try to put it in a proper way. You also do it, students, in a proper way. Only you have to do J. Okay, only one letter J. Okay, students, I hope you all of you got it. So, this much only with the textual questions. Now, be ready with your notebook notes. Notebook notes, you know in which book you have to write. Yes, English notebook. Okay, students, do it proper way. First, you will write poem, number, heading, then date, who likes the rain, date also you will mention. Then, question number 1, give the rhyming words for track, quack, second one head, pen, third one pour, door, drop, stop, pool, school, roof, proof, B, C. Okay, students, do it in your notebook. Nicely you can write, okay? Don't worry, you can pause it and you can write. Okay, students? Next one, question number 2. Answer the following. Question number 1. Do you like the rain? Why? So, answer is, yes, comma you have to put, I like the rain because it is fun to get wet in the rain. Okay, students? Now, next one, question 2. What kind of clothes would you wear if you went out in the rain? We would wear raincoat and gumboots. Yes, students, you are wearing raincoat and gumboots when in rainy season? Good. Okay. So, this way you can pause it and you can write. Okay, students? Now, question number 3. What sound do these animals make? So, you have done, remember you have done in this textual question with the help of the picture and help box. So, here you are, don't have any picture, but you should know which animal makes which sound. Duck, quack. Cow, moo. Hen, cluck. Owl, hook. Horse, neigh. Goat, bah. Okay, students, do it this properly. Okay, with nice handwriting. Don't be lazy. Do it properly and listen to your parents. Okay, students, do it properly. Anytime I will check. Okay, I'll call and I will ask your parents, you are writing or not, you are studying or not. Okay, students, do it very well. Okay, Sarah.